Ultimate maximum moisture, ultimate penetration, higher vibration, wash day experience. Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Shireen Warren. I'm the founder of Ivy Wild. We are a high performance natural hair care products company catering for textured hair types. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I achieved this beautiful braid out using only Ivy Wild products from start to finish. As you can see, my hair is super defined, it's fluffy, it's bouncy, it's got a lot of life to it. Okay, so today I'm giving you guys literally the full Ivy Wild experience with all of the Ivy Wild wash day products, pretty much almost all of them. So my scalp is quite dry at the moment, it's a little bit flaky. As I've mentioned before, I actually suffer from scalp psoriasis, which flares up from time to time, usually when I'm quite stressed. So the main thing that I'll notice is I'll get quite a lot of flakes in areas predominantly around just my hairline, so more so like here, sometimes back here and here. And then I've noticed from time to time I get a little bit just at the back here, so it's not all over the scalp, it's just in like patchy kind of areas of the scalp. Something I have been researching into is an ingredient called ketoconazole. And this ingredient is actually used in a lot of medicated shampoos, which I actually was using before to treat my psoriasis. So when you go to the doctors, they will recommend you that you use a product with ketoconazole in it, provided that you're not breastfeeding and you're not pregnant. The main issue that I've come across with ketoconazole is that it can be a harmful ingredient that can be linked to injury of the liver. This is actually backed by UK government research. I actually came across a UK government website which recommended people and doctors not to recommend ketoconazole or products with ketoconazole in it at all, specifically if it is an oral treatment. My thing is though, if you're orally taking ketoconazole, so in the form of a tablet, it's going into your body, whereas if it's as a topical treatment, it's also being absorbed into the bloodstream. For me, I prefer not to use that at all. Whether you're pregnant or not, I think it's still causing some level of harm. And that's why this product, the Ivy Wild Exfoliating Scalp Scrub, is so amazing. And this is going to be the first thing that we use for our wash day. It's going to be the thing that I use to help get rid of my flakes and the suffering of my psoriasis. It definitely just helps to clear that up. It has apple cider vinegar, it has aloe vera juice, it has shea butter and Himalayan sea salt as key ingredients to fight against flaky scalp. I would recommend this as a natural alternative to products that contain ketoconazole because it's going to help clear up and do pretty much the same thing as those products anyway. They aren't permanent fixtures, they aren't things that you can use as a treatment and they last and they work every single time. But this would absolutely do wonders for you. I'm actually proudest of this product because I think it's really going to help a lot of people. Whether you're pregnant or you're not pregnant, it's suitable for you. So I will show you how to use this product shortly. So the two products I'm going to be washing my hair with is the hydrating shampoo. So this is a cleansing shampoo for the scalp. And then I'm going to follow up with the moisturizing conditioner as well. And both of these products contain mangongo oil. Mangongo oil is from the Menketi tree in Zimbabwe. And oh my gosh, you guys, it's literally coconut oil and steroids. Just so people know, this shampoo does contain coconut oil, whereas the moisturizing conditioner doesn't have any coconut oil in at all. I'm really excited about using these products because I believe every person, every curly and afro girl, man, needs these two products in their wash day routine. They are staple products. The next product that I'm going to be using, and this is for intense deep conditioning, guys. This has protein in it, and it is just amazing. The curls are just so defined after using this. I'm really looking forward to the deep conditioning process. I actually have a thermal cap that I'm going to be using to make sure I get that deep penetration within the hair strands. This product has Baruchi oil. Baruchi oil is from the Baruchi tree in South America. It has phytokeratin, silk amino acids and mango butter as well. So for the whole wash experience, those are the products I'm going to be using. So that's four products that I'm going to be using. Really looking forward to the feel and the texture of my hair. Just so you guys know, like, my hair is super dry at the moment. But by the way, look how my edges have finally grown back. Yay. And then you guys, I'm super excited to share with you our new family member. We have a new member to the family. This is the Ivy Wild foam styling mousse, and I'm super proud of this because I really challenged myself and I thought, what do people really need when it comes to definition? I have been rocking braid outs like no one's business recently, and the main reason for that is because I've constantly been testing this foam styling mousse. I wanted to make sure I got it right, and I think when I like look at brands in America and how the women in America embrace their natural hair, they always have that proper defined braid out or twist out, and I think this is the key staple product that people are going to need to be able to achieve beautiful braid outs and beautiful twist outs. Can I just show you the packaging very quickly? Because as you guys know, I design all my packaging, all my labels myself. It's probably the thing I'm most proud about when it comes to making these products, because just its design, it makes it look beautiful. I don't know if you can see, actually, I might have to do a little, oh, there you go. Can you see it? So it's got like bubbles, foam bubbles on the actual packaging. In here you have jojoba oil, you have argan oil, aloe vera juice, and honey, and phytokeratin as well. So all those ingredients that you need to make sure that your braid out is hydrated and nourished. During my braid out, I'm actually going to be using the curl conditioning butter as well, just to sealing that moisture. And they are going to be all of the products that I'm going to be using for the ultimate maximum moisture, ultimate penetration, higher vibration wash day experience. It's an extravaganza. Okay, let's get started. So I actually am going to show you what my scalp is looking like up close. It's actually not that bad. You guys, I need to find a picture of what my scalp used to be like, because the way it is now, obviously it's improved a lot since using Ivy Wild products, but the way it was before, it was so embarrassing. I'm telling you, like, I could not wear black. Like, if I had my hair out and I was parting my hair like I am now, and this was about a year ago, the amount of flakage that would be on this jumper right now because it's black, like, it was devastating. I could not rock black at all. You know when you've got too much build up on your scalp, because it will feel itchy all around here. It's quite itchy. The back of my hair is itchy, and they are key indications that we need some attention. We need a bit of love for the scalp. So I'm going to go in and use the exfoliated scalp scrub. I'm going to get a towel first. So just to show you what the texture looks like, it is really thick. It's pink. It's like a really cute cloud pink color. Let me just show you the packaging of this as well. So just to show you, if I come up with you, it's so pretty. It's super duper pretty. And yeah, we're taking you to new levels, new heights with this, guys. So I'm just going to show you the texture of it. So it's still quite like crystallized, but still quite buttery. It's not going to be too harsh on your scalp because it has shea butter in there. I'm just going to use it on the areas that I feel it needs the most amount of attention and love. So I'm just going to put that, gently rub it in. So when you do this, add a bit of water to the scalp. I'm not going to do that right now because I think recording it and trying to add water, it will literally be dripping down my face. So for the purposes of this recording, and that feels so good, for the purposes of this recording, I am not going to do that. But when you're at home and you've got this, the best thing to do is put water on the scalp first, and probably do it in the shower because it will help the product to spread evenly across your scalp. And I'm being very gentle, guys. I'm not scrubbing my scalp. It doesn't need further scrubbing with the scrub. I'm now going to go into the bathroom and begin the wash day process with the shampoo, the conditioner, and the deep conditioner as well.
Hey guys, welcome to my bathroom. This is me in the shower. Apologies, my voice might sound different because since recording this, I've not been very well, so my voice is croaky. Here I'm going to use the hydrating shampoo. It's super gloopy. As you can see, it's perfect. I love scrubbing my scalp. It feels so nice. and I just made sure that I rinsed out all of the exfoliating scrub first before I went in with the hydrating shampoo. Just having a little bop, as you do. So I'm rinsing all the shampoo out of my hair, and it's such a soothing feeling. I then use the conditioner to make sure I'm working my strands and just putting all that nourishment back into the strands with the conditioner itself. And then I just rinse it out. Look at that, fantastic.
So now I'm going to use the Intensive Deep Conditioner in my hair, and I just want to show you how nice and thick and gloopy it looks. So you can feel it's fluffier, it's bouncier, the elasticity has already come back just from that wash. And now you wait until you see what my hair's like after I've used this Intensive Deep Conditioner. So I'm just going to apply it all over, and it smells amazing, by the way. And then we also want to pay particular amounts of attention to the ends of our hair as well. Now I'm going to put my thermal mask on. I'm going to protect the thermal mask by using one of these shower caps. I put my thermal mask in the microwave for about 2 minutes, I think it was. I'm going to wait for about 10-15 minutes and then I'm going to rinse it out.
I hope you guys are appreciating that I just put on a wet bathing suit to record this for you. Please, it was not nice. It was very, very wet. It was not very comfortable. But we do what we've got to do to make you guys happy. You can see how lovely my hair looks, guys, from keeping that deep conditioner on for 15 minutes. Beautiful. My hair's drenched. It's hydrated. And that's exactly what we want. The protein that's in the deep conditioner is exactly what my hair needs. Beautiful.
Okay, so my hair's been washed with the hydrating shampoo, moisturising conditioner and the intensive deep conditioner as well. My hair's still quite damp, but we want it to be damp. We still want a little bit of moisture in it. It's not completely dry. And what I'm now going to use is the foam styling mousse and the curl conditioning butter. And we're going to pair these together to create the most amazing, most nourished braid out you've ever seen in your entire life. So I'm going to start at the back of my hair, and the first row is going to be for two braids. So now I'm going to part that to do two braids. Just down the middle there, like that. And I've got another bubble, and I'm going to just use that to section that across. So, moment of truth, what does this foam look like? I'm going to shake it up a little bit, and then I'm going to just use about that much. That's probably too much, to be honest. And I'm going to work that through my hair. So I've got the foam in that section of my hair. I'm then going to use the curl conditioning butter. So I'm probably going to use about that much for this one section. I need more than that. I'm going to take a Denman brush and start at the ends of my hair and then work my way up. I'm going to put a little bit more curl conditioning butter in actually. And then I'm just going to do a braid. So I'm going to make it quite tight to the scalp. So, and then I'm just going to braid my hair. If you can't see product oozing out of the braid, that means you haven't got enough product in it. As I get further to the end, I'm going to take a little bit more curl conditioning butter and it's kind of almost like sealing the braid and making sure that the ends have got enough of the curl conditioning butter on. Two reasons why I'm doing this. Partly because I want the curl at the bottom to be really, really defined, and also because it adds just a little bit of weight to the actual end of the braid as well, and that's what we want really. We want our hair to kind of sit as long as we possibly can, because when we finish taking the braids out, you're obviously going to have that little bit of stretch that you want. As I'm getting nearer to the ends, as mentioned, I'm going to put a little bit of curl conditioning butter towards the ends of the hair, and all I'm doing is I'm going to finish braiding it to the as far down as I possibly can, and I'm going to hold the hair and I'm just going to basically curl it up, as in twist it up the braid, and that's how you get that little knot thing at the end. It isn't a knot though, so when I take my braids out, I'm going to loosen the end first, and it's really easy to do. I'm just going to pull it out like that, and it comes out. That's how easy it will come out. But what we want to do, you can even twist the end a little bit, is seal the end of the braid by curling it up the braid like that. So now that I've done those two sections, let me turn around for you. I'm going to create another parting. This time I'm going to create a braid, probably three, I think. I'm going to do a braid of three, but the aim is to hide that little parting that I've done for the bottom row. So we want to hide this part. So my third braid is going to be above that part, so that when we loosen up the braid, you're not seeing partings in your hair so much. So that's done, I've twisted everything. I just want to show you guys what the back looks like. If I can turn around and show you. So I'll move these out of the way just to show you. So these two braids at the bottom, and then there's three braids across here. And this third braid in the middle will sit above this parting, so that you can't see that bottom parting behind your head. And then I've got two corners to the side. And then when I take it out and I fluff out this back braid here, you won't see that part in there or that part in on that side as well. So there is a technique to how I create my braids for a braid out. We really need to make sure that it's thoroughly dry before we take out the braids, otherwise the definition, it will just be flimsy and floppy, and that's not what we want. We want beautiful defined curls. So I'm going to leave my hair like this until tomorrow morning, and yeah, I'm really happy with how it looks so far. I'm looking forward to showing you guys what the finished braid out will be like, and I've just noticed I've missed a tiny bit of hair, but look how long that is, you guys. So today is the next day. As you can see, I had a very good sleep. My hair is sticking up. What I'm going to do now is use the scalp soother oil to actually unbraid my hair. The reason why I'm using the scalp soother oil to do this is because it helps the definition, and it makes your hair just nice and shiny as you're doing it. So I'm just going to take the pipette, and I'm actually going to put the pipette on the braid itself. And as mentioned, I'm gently uncoiling the ends, so there's no kind of knotting or anything, it's just a gentle uncoiling. So just to quickly show you just how pretty that braid has come out, and it's nice and bouncy, and the curl is just beautiful. It's looking super full on this side, a little bit thinner on this side. Look at this little cute thing in the front here. Let me just show you how long my hair actually is. Yes, the overall definition in my curls are absolutely amazing. My curls are looking gorgeous, they are just full of life. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Bye for now.